Gender roles in films have constantly been shaping the society that surrounds us. From young boys to teenage girls, Disney gender stereotypes have influenced children all over the world. Teenagers may not watch Disney movies any longer. However, the Disney princesses and princes who they grew up with and idolized definitely impacted their self-esteem to date. The main problem we have with Disney movies, whether they're out of date or present, is that we do not teach young kids enough that the stereotypes and gender roles portrayed in Disney movies are wrong.
My favorite Disney princess has to be Cinderella. Ever since I was a little girl, I've always wanted to be her.
I never realized that by watching Disney movies, my self-esteem would lower until I realized that I would never look like the prince that would get the princess.
Think of instead a girl worth fighting for.
Huh?
That's what I said, a girl worth fighting for. I want her paler than the moon, with eyes that shine like stars.
My girl will marvel at my strength, adore my battle scars.
I couldn't care less what she'll wear or what she looks like. It all depends on what she cooks, like beef, pork, chicken.
Well, I think that Disney teaches females and males that women and men are attracted to the opposite sex. Never do we see a prince and a princess liking the same sex.
And I'll bet the ladies love a man in armor.
You can guess what we have missed the most.
What do we want?
A girl worth fighting for.
My girl will think I have no faults.
That I'm a major find.
How about a girl who's got a brain? Who always speaks her mind?
Nah.
Did you ever watch princess movies as a child?
Yeah, I have two sisters, so I've seen a lot of them.
And what did you notice about all the princes?
In the end, they always go and save the princess. They were always portrayed as the strong one, the hero in the end. Well, I found in movies that side characters were always portrayed as big or really small to be comedic, like LeFou in Beauty and the Beast, and Pumbaa is like really fat hedgehog. I think this tells many boys that if you want to be cool and you want to be the hero, you have to be strong and you have to have all these characteristics to make you look like the best.
Anyone could see that the prince was charming. The only one for me.
Was he strong and handsome? Was he big and tall?
There's nobody like him anywhere at all.
Even though in all these movies the girl is the main character, it's always like the man who always steps in and saves them and takes the main role in the end.
No one's next as incredibly thick as Gaston, for there's no man in town half as manly. Perfect, a pure paragon. You can ask any Tom, Dick, or Stanley, and they'll tell you whose team they prefer to be on. No one's big like Gaston, a kick big like Gaston. No one's got a swell cleft in his chin like Gaston.
As a specimen, yes, I'm intimidating. In a wrestling match, nobody fights like Gaston.
For there's no one as burly and brawny.
As you see, I've got biceps to spare.
Not a bit of him scraggly or scrawny.
That's right. And every last inch of me's covered with hair.
No one gets like
women may feel the need to go to great lengths to become underweight, whereas male adolescents feel the need to gain more muscular weight.
As much as Disney teaches a woman they need a man to save her, Disney teaches boys they need to be that man.
Disney makes villains who are very tall and very angular and sharp defining bodies, and they often give them sidekicks who are short and spout and generally there to be made fun of.
If you are taught that being ugly or fat, as many villains are, is bad, then you will aspire to be the opposite.
The Disney princess body is the epitome of unrealistic body shapes and sizes.
Men want girls with good taste,
calm, obedient,
who work fast-paced, with good breeding,
and a tiny waist.
You'll bring honor to us all.
69% of high school and elementary students, girls, model their ideal body image off of magazine images and the media.
50% of teenage girls use unhealthy weight control behaviors such as skipping meals, fasting, and smoking cigarettes to control their weight.
Who was your favorite princess as a child?
My favorite princess as a child would be Jasmine.
And why did you like Jasmine?
I like Jasmine because she was confident and very pretty.
Jasmine, you're very...
wonderful, magnificent, glorious, punctual.
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 Sorry.
Beautiful.
Nice recovery.
I'm rich too, you know.
Yeah.
The daughter of a sultan.
I know.
A fine prize for any prince to marry.
Right. A prince like me.
Right. A prince like you. And every other stuffed shirt, swaggering peacock
wait.
I've met.
In new movies like Tangled, Frozen, and Brave, they're afraid to show who they really are. They're strong and confident.
Many people complain that Disney princesses teach girls that they need their man to save them. However, they should cherish love and also be able to take care of themselves.
Firstborn descendant of Glan Dunbrog, and I'll be shooting for my own hand.
What are you doing?
Merida! Curse this dress!
Being like the old princesses, Cinderella and Snow White, I want to be one of the new ones, like Elsa and Merida. I want to be myself.
Progress and improvements have been made in recent films from the 2000s compared to Disney films from the 1930s. Characters have much less of a structured, stereotypical gender role in which they follow. However, Disney still has a long way to go until all stereotypes in their animated movies are broken. Change is happening. Young boys and girls are beginning to develop and be influenced by these new Disney movies. Is there hope for a stereotypical gender role-free world for the children of tomorrow? You can join the conversation at www.theothersideofthemirror.ca. So that the princess of tomorrow don't follow in Gaston's footsteps, and the princesses of tomorrow are free to shoot their own arrows.